The situation in Iraq is very much a transitional situation. So, because the main media, main publicity, the main attention has gone away from Mosul to other emergencies in other parts of the world, it doesn't mean that the emergency throughout the country has finished. So there are still more than 2.5 million people displaced. There are still active conflict or pockets of conflict ongoing in different parts of the country. And it's transitional in that people have started to return to their homes, to their areas of origin. I mean, when you go out and you visit places in Iraq, the first thing that will strike you is the level of damage and destruction. It's different from one place to another, but in some of the major cities like Mosul in particular, Fallujah, Ramadi, areas in western Anbar, western Nineveh as well. The damage and the destruction is incredible. You'll go through places and just see nothing but bricks, rubble, bricks, everything is in piles. Roads, bridges, schools, health facilities, all of the basic infrastructure is very, very heavily damaged and destroyed. And this hits you immediately, and the first reflection you have is to wonder how people are going to live. And then at the same time, you're often surprised by the number of people that have already gone back to these places, or in some cases, people that remained in these areas. And it's surprising, even shocking, that people manage to live in these conditions. So that's the first thing that you notice when you go to these areas. Then when you start to meet with people and speak with people and ask them what the situation is like, what life has been like for the last few years, how things are for them at the moment, then it really depends on the area because there are different needs in different places. But one of the things which is also quite striking is the mental health. Again, people are actually quite self-aware. And this is something you don't necessarily see anywhere else in the world, even in the UK, even in France, for example. There's a huge stigma, or there's a reluctance for people to admit that there are any kind of mental health impact or needs, for example. Whereas because of the level of trauma and the scale of need in terms of support for mental health disorders is so big in Iraq, people are actually aware of this. And so people proactively will come to us, come to other organizations, for example, to request